long development. We start new note or information about anatomy and physiology of lung development. Lung development, first, prenatal lung development. The lung bud arises as pouch from the primitive foregut at 22 to 26 day of gestation. يعني lung bud arise from the primitive gut. The first month of gestation. The bronchial tree develops between 5th and 16 weeks of gestation by continuous budding and branching of the airway. Airway branching end at 16 weeks of gestation. Further develop growth occur by increase in the diameter and the length, but not by increase in the airway number. So the insult to the lung before 16 week of gestation will lead to decrease both airway number and subsequent alveolar growth and number. So the insult to the lung before 16 weeks will be affected bronchial and alveolar number. But the insult after 16 weeks of gestation affected only alveolar number and the growth. Second, postnatal lung development. Approximately 60 million of primitive alveoli exist at birth. At birth, the unit develop with 60 million of alveoli. The lung grows most rapidly in alveolar number during the first 2 years of life. The growth rate decreases then after until the adult number of approximately 375 million alveoli is reached at age of 8 to 12 years. So the number of the alveoli and the development of the lung will be completed at age of 8 to 12 years. Common pathologic feature of pulmonary disease. Underlying pathological process, most of the lung disease in the children are classified as obstructive, which mean airway narrowing. So the main pathology of the lung, we have two types, either obstructive or restrictive. Obstructive, which mean airway narrowing, may be caused by intraluminal secretion, edema, or inflammation, hypertrophy, or contraction of the bronchial smooth muscle, or extrinsic compression. This is all cause obstruction. The second, restriction, which mean impaired lung expansion, may be caused by decreased lung compliance, atelectasis, pneumothorax will cause lung collapse, neuromuscular disease, and disorder of chest wall. All these causes will cause restriction of the lung movement, and this cause restriction pathology. Pathophysiology, we have hypoxemia, which means deficient oxygenation of the blood, most commonly caused by ventilation, perfusion abnormalities, but may be result of intracardiac or intrapulmonary shunt or hypoventilation. Hypercapnia, which means excess carbon dioxide in the blood caused commonly by hypoventilation due to upper airway obstruction, neuromuscular weakness, or CNS depression. Pathological factor, the small airway of the child result in hyper airway resistance and put the child at great risk for develop of obstructive lung disease. So the child, because have small airway, is more prone to have obstructive lung disease than adult. The boy are affected more than girls and more than severely than girls, in part because the peripheral airway in the boy is younger than 5 years of girls than those of the girls. The boys is more affected than girls before 5 years because the boys have narrower airway than girls. The young child lack specific immunity. In the children, most pulmonary disease have single cause, where in adult pulmonary disease is maybe multifactorial in the etiology. Now, this is short introduction about anatomy and physiology of lung disease. We have first, we start by congenital stridor. Congenital stridor, which means the stridor that start from birth. The causes of congenital stridor, first, laryngomalacia, which consists about more than 70% of the cases, focal cord paralysis, subglottic stenosis, cysts, web, vascular anomaly, cleft larynx, laryngoangioma, and subglottic hemangioma. All these causes of congenital stridor, which means the stridor that start at birth. The most common one and the most important one is a laryngomalacia and tracheomalacia. Laryngomalacia and tracheomalacia the stridor persisting or appear after the first few days of life usually result from disturbance to the larynx. So it is a congenital stridor. Laryngomalacia and tracheomalacia is a congenital stridor, start after few days of the birth. The most common cause are laryngomalacia and tracheomalacia due to floppiness of the epiglottis and subglottic and weakness of the airway will leading to the collapse and sometimes airway obstruction with inspiration. So the laryngomalacia and tracheomalacia, it is the most important cause of congenital stridor. What is the pathology? The pathology is the floppiness of the epiglottis, and this will lead to the collapse of the epiglottis while taking inspiration. You see, this is normal larynx. This is the normal larynx. While these two pictures will show floppiness of the epiglottis and the complete obstruction of the epiglottis while taking inspiration will lead to stridor. Clinical feature, noisy respiration sound usually associated with inspiration are relatively common during the neonatal period and the first year of life. Stridor may present at birth or maybe after 2 months. Mostly affect the male, mostly affected than female. The symptom can be intermittent and worse when the affected infant lie on his back. So the symptom, the main symptom is the stridor, which is started at birth, and this stridor will become worse when the child is lying on his back. So when the child lying on his back, the stridor will be increased. Some infant will be develop dyspnea, inspiratory retraction in the supraclavicular, intercostal, and the subcostal space. So in addition to the stridor, we have sign of the respiratory distress, which is intercostal recession, subcostal recession, and supraclavicular retraction. The stridor typically is loudest when the child is a feeding or quietly relaxation. The stridor become loud when the child feed or when his neck is flexed, like this. When his neck is flexed, the stridor will be increased. So the stridor increase when the child, the mother said, when the child is a feeding, when taking feeding, the stridor will be increased. Or when the neck of the child is flexed like this, the stridor also will be increased. And the stridor will be diminished during the sleep and when the child is crying. While when the child is asleep, the stridor will be diminished. The stridor usually resolve by age of 2 months, but may be recur with respiratory tract infection until about 3 years of age. So the stridor is a temporarily, not lifelong, and disappear most of the cases by age of 1 year, but sometime will be recur with upper respiratory tract infection up to the age of 3 years of life. Diagnosis, the diagnosis by fibro-optic bronchoscope or by direct laryngoscope, which mean inspect of the larynx when the child will be take inspiration, will see the epiglottis will be collapsed. And this is the diagnosis. So the diagnosis by bronchoscope or laryngoscope, which means by vision. You see the larynx will be collapsed when the child will take inspiration. Therapy is usually not needed. No specific treatment is needed. The parent should be reassured and provide careful feeding. Sometimes need small nibble. Rarely tracheostomy is required when the stridor occur in failure to thrive or when there is a life-threatening apnea or obstruction. In general, no specific treatment is needed, and the condition, as I said, is a temporarily and disappear spontaneously. But sometimes we need tracheostomy when the stridor, when the child is failure to thrive, or when the child is develop apnea. The other causes of congenital stridor is a subglottic stenosis. Subglottic stenosis is a common problem that may be congenital or iatrogenic due to aggressive management of the premature infant with intubation and mechanical ventilation may produce residual damage to the larynx. Infants with Down syndrome appear to have small larynx and most susceptible or subglottic stenosis. Subglottic stenosis will produce stridor and evidence of obstruction will be present on the expiration and inspiration. This is the difference. The stridor in the subglottic stenosis is usually present during both inspiration and expiration. While in the tracheomalacia and laryngeomalacia, the stridor only present during the inspiration. So in the subglottic stenosis, the stridor present in the two phases of respiration, inspiration, and expiration. With increased degree of respiratory effort, the stridor will be worse with viral infection. Definitive diagnosis require endoscopic evaluation. So the diagnosis by direct vision of the stenotic area by endoscope. The treatment may be necessary tracheostomy, however, mild congenital causes improve with the age as larynx grow. Okay? This is picture will be shown. This is normal larynx and the normal trachea. While this slide will show subglottic stenosis. You see the difference? This is normal and this is subglottic stenosis. Vascular ring. The other causes of congenital stridor, vascular ring, congenital anomalies of the aortic arch or its branches can create a ring around the airway that compression of respiration. The clinical feature, if the vascular ring produces compression of the trachea and esophagus, the symptoms are frequently present at infancy. Chronic stridor and wheezes exacerbated by crying, feeding, and flexion of the neck. Extension of the neck tend to relieve the noisy respiration. Vomiting is frequent. So the clinical feature, it is started at birth also by stridor, difficulty in feeding, and this stridor usually exacerbate or increase by crying or flexion of the neck. While extension of the neck, retraction of the neck backward, this will lead to relief of the stridor. Diagnosis, X-ray examination of barium filled esophagus, arteriography, two-dimensional echo, MRI, CT scan, or angiography. Bronchoscope may be used to assess airway narrowing. The condition is not improved with age, so need treatment by surgery. At reverse, the others, tracheomalacia, subglottic stenosis, which resolve spontaneously in case of vascular ring, does not disappear spontaneously, so need for surgical treatment. This slide will be show the vascular ring. This is the esophagus, and this is the trachea, and this is the aorta. This is normal anatomy. While in case of the vascular ring, you see this is a branch will arise from the aorta, will encircle the trachea and the esophagus. In this slide, in the right side, you see a branch arise from aorta, will encircle the esophagus and trachea. Hemangioma, other causes of congenital stridor, a number of masses lesion affected the larynx, but most commonly hemangioma that usually found in subglottic space. The infant with stridor should be examined head to the toe for cutaneous hemangioma because the presence of such lesion greatly increased the likelihood that stridor is due to subglottic hemangioma. So when we found cutaneous hemangioma and the child has stridor, congenital stridor, the cause of the congenital stridor is most likely subglottic hemangioma because the cutaneous hemangioma associated with other hemangioma in other part of the body. The airway obstruction usually worse with crying and maybe reduce pulmonary hypertension. The diagnosis depend on the endoscope and maybe by anterior posterior X-ray of the larynx. The treatment are controversial, maybe tracheostomy, other laser therapy or steroid. As with other hemangioma, spontaneous regression is a rule, but maybe need years. So the treatment maybe need laser therapy, but sometimes disappear as other type of hemangioma, cutaneous hemangioma, which disappear spontaneously and not need for treatment. This slide will show, these slides will be show laryngeal hemangioma. You see, this is the area, this is the area, this is the area, this area of hemangioma. Pulmonary sequestration, the other cause, a cyst-like mass of non-functioning lung tissue which lack normal communication with the tracheobronchial tree, sometimes developed at the embryo, most often within the lower lobe. The non-functioning part is nourished by systemic arteries. Clinical feature, infection can result if the fistula develop between the sequestration. The children usually present with the history of recurrent persistence, progressive pulmonary sepsis or lung abscess. Diagnosis of lung sequestration first by X-ray, which usually show the sequestration as area of density with displacement of bronchovascular marking. Contrast bronchography maybe show sequestration as area filled to fill with the contrast. Arteriography will delineate the anomalies artery supply from the aorta. Treatment is a surgical removal of sequestration area. The most important part in the lecture is a foreign body aspiration. This is a common and one of the emergencies in the pediatric is a foreign body aspiration. The majority of the patients are less than 4 years, and most of the deaths also occur in this age. Younger children most commonly aspirate foods and toys. Clinical feature, a high number of the children who aspirate foreign body will present with either clear cut history of choking or physical or X-ray evidence of foreign body aspiration. However, small percentage of the patient with foreign body aspirate will have negative history because an observed or unrecognized event. So most of the child with foreign body aspiration give history of choking. So most of the patient with foreign body aspiration give history of choking while he is eating or while he is playing with the small toys. Physical finding consistent with acute foreign body aspirate include unilateral absence of breath sound, localized wheezes, stridor, or bloody subbutum. X-ray may reveal the presence of radiobic when the aspiration suspected expiratory film should be requested. Because the right main bronchus is a more direct continuous with the trachea than the left main bronchus, the foreign bodies tend to be enter the right lung more. Some foreign bodies, especially nuts or seeds, may be migrate from the place to the place in the airway and even lodge in the larynx and covering totally occluding the airway. Foreign body also may be locked in the esophagus and compress the trachea, produce respiratory symptom. So the location of the impact foreign body, you see the right main bronchus is the most common site. The right main bronchus is the most common site because direct continuation of the right main bronchus with the trachea. The other larynx, trachea, is the least area of impaction. The stages or phases of foreign body aspiration, initial phase, choking, gasping, covering of airway obstruction at the time of aspiration. This is the first stage, asymptomatic phase, subsequent lodging of the object with relaxation of the reflex that often result in the reduction or cessation of the symptom lasting for the first hour. So the initial phase is the phase of choking. In this phase, the child will be coughing and gasping. The second stage asymptomatic phase, when the foreign body is a log, yes, sir, the symptom will be disappear. And the last stage will complication phase, foreign body produce erosion or obstruction will leading to pneumonia, atelectasis, or abscess. Diagnosis, the majority of the body are small and quickly covering out, but many maybe remain in the lung for long period before diagnosis and maybe come to the medical attention because of symptom of fever, cough, subutum production, or chest pain. Patient with persistent wheeze, unresponsive to the bronchodilator therapy, persistent atelectasis, recurrent or persistent pneumonia, or persistent coughing without explanation should be suspected foreign body. So the patient with persistent wheeze, unresponsive to the bronchodilator, the patient with recurrent pneumonia, the patient with persistent atelectasis should be suspected foreign body aspiration. If there is a good evidence in the history, physical examination, or by film for bronchial foreign body, the patient should be undergo rigid bronchoscope. The flexible bronchoscopy may be very useful for diagnosis when the presentation is not straightforward. So the diagnosis and the treatment is by bronchoscope. Prevention, the best approach to the foreign body aspiration to educate the parent and infant that the child not eat the food that cutting to small pieces and notably in the small toe. This chest x-ray will be shown foreign body aspiration in the form of screw in the bronchus and will cause atelectasis of left lung. And thank you.